thank you very much for joining us today, viewers. Today we're going to be discussing about the recently held MDC Congress. What does it signify? And also being the very important after the death of Tsvangirai. With me today, I've got Comrade Gwisai, a leading member of the ISO. Welcome, Comrade.
Thank you. Welcome, Comrade Willett, and welcome, viewers.
Okay. As you know, the recent held Congress, Comrade Gwisai, we want to hear from you. What is your take on the recent MDC Congress?
Thank you, Comrade Che, and I welcome this initiative that you have started as young socialists, young comrades, to continue with the tradition of socialist history, working class history, and student history of this country. This Congress is very important in many respects. It's the MDC celebrates 20 years. The MDC represents one of the most powerful parties that was built from the struggles against structural adjustment programs, against neoliberalism, and indeed in many ways against capitalism, and has waged one of the most vicious, one of the most biggest fights against a vicious authoritarian dictatorship led by Mugabe. So, but what happens to the MDC matters therefore as history for the young workers of today. It's important as history of the working class of this country, but of our region and in the global south. Because from the history of the MDC, we are able to learn the massive power and potential of ordinary people, of workers, to cause change and fight for change in society away from the fat cats, the bosses, the employers, the politicians who take this society, this country, as if it is for them alone, and who thrive on the sweat and exploitation of our workers, of our rural farmers, of the informal sector. That is the capitalist class. So the MDC was an important chapter in that sense. And today, as workers, ordinary people fight in Sudan, in Algeria, in South Africa, it has important lessons. But what is important, it's both an inspiring history, but it's also a history that has a lot of lessons in terms of what to avoid. This Congress, 20 years down the line, the first one since Tsvangirai, the founding leader of the party, died, as well as other labor leaders like Gibson Sibanda, Mutsengerere, Matombo, and others who are now led. This is a it reflects a fundamental shift in the balance of power, a fundamental change in the nature of the MDC. The MDC was formed primarily, fundamentally, as a reaction led by trade unions and workers against Mugabe's government's shift to austerity policies, neoliberal policies, free market policies. Today, this is called Zimbabwe's Open for Business by Mnangagwa, the Mnangagwa Chiwenga Junda, and the right wingers of the MDC, led by Tendai Biti, call it ease of doing business. So the MDC was formed against exactly that, but also against the dictatorship of the Mugabe Junda in order to fight for greater democratization of society. But right from the word go, whilst it was formed by workers, radicalizing workers, whilst it was formed by radicalizing students, including the likes of Chamisa, who is now President, Wende Chauton, who is now the General Secretary, but others who are not in, like Job Scala himself, who is now the Deputy Chairperson in MDC, but outside the MDC, those like Hopewell Gumbo, Takura Jangaja, and others of that generation. They were part of a radical anti-capitalist student movement that joined up with radicalizing workers, as well as the left, the socialists ourselves from ISO. But there was also always a small minority right-wing neoliberal element from the NGO world, in particular from the NCA, that also became part of this process. But as a small minority junior section in this, this party was built as a working class party. That was the objective, and that is what was fought for. Mm. That is why you have founding leaders were drawn predominantly from the labor movement. Tsvangirai himself, as president of the party, former general secretary of the ZCTU, Zimbabwe Congress of Trade Unions. Gibson Sibanda, who was the president of the ZCTU, became Tsvangirai's deputy president. The first chairman of the party, Isaac Matongo, who had been the president of the National Engineering Workers Union. The national organizer, Enos Mhlonga, also a trade unionist. Then you had the leadership of the women, the Women's Assembly, Lucia Matienga, but also involved other women trade unionists like Kupe Tokozani, Matienga was the chairperson, Paulina Mpariwa, Kumbi Kudenga, and a number of Gertrude Mtombeni, very important ZCTU trade union leader. And the chairpersons of regions of the province of the MDC, all the 10 provinces were led by trade union leaders. So you can, but you had a few students. Lenmo Jongwe, who had been a leader in the student bodies in ASU, became the first spokesperson. Chamisa Nelson, who was also the general secretary of the students' union. Zinasu and president of the SRC at Poly became the youth chairperson. But these were very radical socialist student activists who had been members of the ISO from about, so for people like Wende, members of the ISO, set up ISO structures as early as 1995 at the Polytechnic. Lenmo Jongwe, leading member of the ISO at the University of Zimbabwe. And in fact, that cadership of Lenmo Jongwe, Charlton Wende, Marco Abraham, Chimbalu, John Chipunza, had been the key section of student ISO student members who had participated in the historic August 1996 government worker strike, bringing together nurses, doctors, and other government workers in the first general strike by government workers. So they were coming from that tradition. People like Nelson Chamisa would have joined the ISO around 1998. We had a very strong ISO branch at the Harare Polytechnic. Now people like Pedzisai Ruhanya, who were now Dr. Ruhanya, now who were students at the MASCOM, would also have been members of the ISO branch at the Polytech. So it was this component of workers, trade unionists, crucially radical, anti-capitalist socialist students. Then you would have had those who came in through the NCA, crucially people like Welsh Mengnuwe. Tsvangirai was also the chairperson of the NCA, National Constitutional Assembly. So he brought along a number of his people from there. That would have included, crucially, as I say, people like Welsh Mengnuwe. David Coulthard came from the Forum Party. So what you can see here is that this was a party that was formed, led by the union movement, a radical student movement, some radical academics, after the 1999 February Working People's Convention. And it was a working people's party. That is why the conference that established the party was called Working People's Convention, organized, funded, run by the ZCTU. But what you now have since that time, today, why this Congress is important, is that that generation is gone. But what we now have is that that right-wing, neoliberal, reactionary element, which was a minority, has now taken over the party.
Mm, mm.
The party has now gone through a 360-degree change, and we now have an elite takeover of a party that was formed to fight austerity, a party that was formed to fight dictatorship, a party that was formed for working people, has now been taken over. I remember reading a very important interview by Nelson Chamisa in 2003 when he was the chairperson of or the president of the Youth Assembly. And he says that even for him to become the chairperson of the Youth Assembly, he had faced resistance from right, what he calls neoliberal right-wing forces, which had opposed him because they knew his history in terms of the ISO, the socialist history, as well as radical history. And he was complaining about how this element was seeking to maneuver its way and manipulate the party.
Mm.
Regrettably, that element represented by the two vice presidents elected, Tendai Biti, Welsh Mengube, they represent the new Treasury General, David Coulthard. Those three represent the right-wing, reactionary, neoliberal, anti-poor, anti-worker, anti-rural farmer, anti-youth element of the MDC. It represents their triumph.
Mm.
Even if you have people like Chamisa himself elected, Wende, and so forth, who come from this radical generation of the late 1990s, there is no doubt that the fundamental direction of this party has now changed to represent the interests of the rich, the interests of Western imperialists, American, British, European, to represent the interests of those who are arguing for austerity, those who are arguing for neoliberalism, Yauraya and Zimbabwe today.
Mm.